everybody. Welcome back to the range. Today, we are doing the one and the only JDC Double Trouble Bill. It is for Jay and Amanda over there at JDC's Diecast Creations. It is for their twin girls that they are going to be having, and I'm going to be mailing this off. So let's head on down to the range and get started. You know, I'm always a big fan of Camaros. I don't care what year they are, really. You know, these 1970 Camaros, you know, I had... Oh, boy. I have quite a lot of these castings just laying around. A couple orange ones and that blue one. You know, I just like doing Camaros. And there's going to be a lot of footage on here that you're not going to see because... Pretty much what I did to one car, I did exactly to the other. So there's a lot of fast forwarding. There's a lot of, you know, here, there, and everywhere. The only thing, other than the way I did the paint, that was different was the wheels. I had two separate sets of wheels that kind of similar. One was all chrome. One had a red line around it. So, you know. I kind of wanted to do something other than that. Yeah, the paint is different as well. But it's the same colors. You know, I did not go two different or different colored cars. Well, in a way I did. But I stuck with two colors for both cars. The only thing different I did was the design. And you'll see what I'm talking about further on in the video. The two colors I used, they worked really good together. And honestly, one of them, I wasn't thinking when I got it. Because I thought it was a different color and it looks more of another color. So, you'll just have to see it for yourself. You know. Because I don't want to give it out at too early into the video. You know, I want to wait till it gets to the paint portion of the video. And pretty much like I said, everything I did to one, casting I did to the other. I smoothed out the base, kind of filed it, or not filed it, but sanded it down. You know, I kind of... made it look similar. Excuse me. Sorry about yawning. It's been a long night. I haven't been to sleep. But, you know, I ended up not using the stock axles. And these weren't like the one, the stock axles. These tires were Real Rider tires that I used. They're solid axles. And I don't like using those. A lot of the times they don't roll, so that's why I end up usually making my own axles. And I ended up putting suspension on both of these castings. I don't know, just something extra to do. It was nothing big or nothing like that. You know, you can tell it's got a suspension when you kind of bounce it up and down on, you know, moving the tires and everything. But you know, same thing as I always use, those little hair clips. And I'm going to be trying some new different ways to do suspensions later on in later videos. But this is one quick way to do a suspension. You know, I kind of had to bend the metal in certain directions to fit the base of the casting so I could still fit the interior onto the base. But it worked out really nice. I like how it worked out. It flowed. You know, the cars look great. I'll be honest with you. I was really impressed with the way the cars turned out. And, you know, there's really not a lot of custom work. Well, actually, there's nothing custom about these other than the paint schemes. You know, and just added suspension. You know, I didn't do anything fancy with them or you know, added a big old spoiler or anything. You know, I added paint and decals. That's pretty much all I added. And suspension. You know, but I got the Mini Cooper build I still got to do. I kind of been slacking on that one. I got till the end of March to get that one done. I already got my Porsche build done. I showed you guys in one of my videos. You know, got my Four Horsemen build already done. You know, you'll be able to see it. So stay tuned to the channel and you'll be able to see it. You know, Double Trouble builds going out next week along with Amanda's over at JDC's customs. Her custom is going out. She's also getting a little bit of an extra custom. But I'm also putting Jay a little something in there. You know, I'm not a big Ferrari guy, and I already talked to Jay about this. I'm like, if I come across any Ferraris, I'll send them your way. You know, because I'm not really big on the newer style Ferraris or anything like that. I try to do more of the classic style cars. You know, you can tell with that with some of my videos, you know, that I pretty much don't really do many videos on newer style cars and or imports or anything like that. But I got this build I'm doing off camera. I'm still kind of, you know, seeing what direction I'm wanting to go with it, because I got a good idea, but I need to get some parts on order, and I'm waiting for parts from Grizz over Bearcat 3D Designs. I'm probably going to end up ordering some certain parts from Benchwork Toys, because I noticed something about them and they work. So, and it helped out, because I'm doing two builds and I use these interior portions that I got from Benchwork Toys for these two builds, and just, you know, a little bit of modifications, a little sanding down and smoothing out and stuff, and they fit perfect. And I'm like, you know what, I'm going to try to do a video on one of those builds. So the first beginning of next week, I'm going to place an order at Benchwork Toys for a couple of parts that, you know, I'm kind of gonna try to get into. I need to get more engines for sure, but Grizz told me he's got a bunch of engines for me, got a bunch of parts for me. You know, unfortunately he had a bad event at his house and he had to redo a lot of parts. And I'm like, dude, I don't care about the parts. As long as you're okay, that's all that matters to me. You know, because life happens, I get it, I understand, but when shit just hits the fan and things just go horribly wrong, I'm not going to be mad. And here's the first color I did. It is a Wicked Pearl Red from Createx. And I'm not showing you the other car. I'm just showing you one car, because I had to paint one just to kind of see what it would look like before I did this one. And all I did was reverse the pattern. So, you see the base of this one's red. Well, the second color, you'll see that here in a minute, is the base color for the other car. So, you know, when I taped it off, and I just kind of did the opposite. See where the thin line's at? It's technically on the passenger side, but on the other car, I did it on the driver's side. And, you know, I just kind of was flip-flopping things. You know, I ended up putting the letters D, T on both the cars. You can kind of make them out. They're a little faded in there, but I like it like that. I think it looks neat like that. You know, I got some stickers, and I was just pretty much using them for like a template stencil or something like that. And, you know, I just wanted it to kind of be a fancy style lettering because there wasn't really many stickers I could find small enough to fit on these cards. And, you know, either way it goes, you know, I'll figure something out. And, you know, I didn't go haywire with the taping. You know, I just kind of was like putting it to where it wasn't going to be covering up the letters. It kind of would look decent. And I got a trailer there, you see, with a couple of, you know, I got a smash car there that's going to go with the winner of the monster truck build that I'm going to be doing for the Monster Jam Challenge, and I'll put some more information out that because I have decided on a date. Gives me plenty of time to build the arena, gives me plenty of time to discuss with Jay and see if maybe he can help me out with some rules and how to do the whole, you know, roll the dice thing. But if I had to, I can make one dice. That's not a big deal. But or paint one dice and then just kind of, that's a good thing about having airbrush paint and markers and stuff, you know. If you don't like the way the dice look, paint it, put your own little dots on it, and there it goes. But anywho, back to the car. You know, I'll like I said, anything that you see here I did on the other car as well. It's just like The racing stripes on the top was just kind of flip-flop, you know, it was on the driver's side on the other car, and this side is on the passenger side. But anyhow, it turned out really neat, and this is the color, the secondary color I went with. It's a pearl magenta, and I really like this color. I'm not into the whole girly colors, but this one really It shined. It really popped. And that was the base I did for the other car. You know, and you see the red and the magenta actually looks really good together. You know, of course, and I'm sorry, I put my decals on the car. You know, I only put two of my decals, but I also put one more decal on there plus license plates. I ended up putting license plates on the car even though I couldn't see what they said. So, Jay, tell me if you can read them when you get them. And what I did was specifically, I had these little minion decals. Mm-hmm. So I took some minion decals, cut two minions out that were standing side by side, same exact ones for the other car, and I put them on one side of the car, one side of this car, and I reversed it on the other side. So the minions are on the passenger side of this car, but yet they're on the driver's side on the other car. And the same game thing goes with my logo here. You know, I got this logo on the driver's side, and on the other car, it's on the passenger side. So I kind of, you know, it's a twin a deal. It's technically twins, but it's just not identical twins. So, see what I'm saying? But, you know, these license plates, I've actually been getting really good with these. You know, I've only put about four on total. But let me go ahead and make it the announcement for the Monster Jam Challenge. Rule number one, we're going to have, it's got to be a monster truck. It has to. Rule number two, you can use any 164 casting. Number three, be creative and have fun. The due date is July 4th, 2022. This is what we started off with. Two good castings. I got better Camaros that I use for my other things, but these were the ones I wanted specifically for this build. Two 1970 Camaro. I love this body style. I love the looks. And yeah, it's just one of my favorites. So why don't we check out the final results? and I'll see you next time at the range.